Hi, this is Justice with TabletPro. So I'm going to show you how I use AstroPad with TabletPro and with Rebel 7, and I'm doing this on an iPad mini. Now, I like this setup quite a bit. There's a couple things that you're going to need to do before this works correctly, so I want to go through those quickly. First things first, let me show you the latency here. There is almost zero latency. This feels fantastic. Now I have a ROG Flow Z13, which has horrible palm rejection issues. Now, if I use this little button here with Tablet Pro, I can pull this up and create a little palm rejection spot, which is typically this bottom right corner where my palm rests. However, with using the iPad, I don't have those issues. It's actually quite nice. I can tap and use the shortcut keys on the left. These are Tablet Pro Studios, and these make this process a whole lot easier. I actually have issues getting AstroPad to send keyboard shortcuts. So let's go ahead and look at a couple settings. The first one that we want to look at, this is a setting inside of iOS. You're going to go to accessibility right here, and inside of accessibility, you're going to go to keyboards and typing, full keyboard access. You're going to turn this off. This causes issues with the keyboard sending input to the application inside of Windows or Mac, whatever you're using this with. All right, so that is step number one. Step number two, inside of Tablet Pro Studio, you want to turn on this little widget right here. This is going to give you access to the keyboard shortcuts and the radio menu. And you definitely want this for all sorts of different interactions because this is actually quite difficult to do using AstroPad setup. For some reason, it does not work for me still, but this does. So this gives me a lot of different options. So in order to turn this on, we're going to go into the Tablet Pro Studio app. You can get to the app a variety of different ways, but we're going to do it this way. Right down here in the corner is the studio icon. It's this orange one, bottom right corner next to the microphone. You may be able to find it here. And the link to get this is in the Microsoft Windows Store. All right, let's go into settings. We tap the top right corner, settings. And inside of settings, we're going to go to radio menu. And then there's an option, always display a radio menu toggle button. This is about halfway down. You can see the locate button here, down halfway, always display a radio menu toggle button. You can also use tilt to open the radio menu, which I'll show you that. And then just click apply. We're just going to click cancel. For Rebel, I have this set up. I would actually like this to be the last radio menu I used. And previous two radio actions, this won't matter because we only have one button on the Apple Pencil. So perhaps in the future we'll have more options. Now, when I double click here, I have this set up inside of AstroPad to toggle between 6 and 7. There we go. And if we want to resize, we can resize this brush very easily and zoom in and zoom out. Pick colors, switch to the eraser, and then we're going to use undo over here, or we can do two finger tap. Now, here inside of AstroPad, these actions can be found. Make sure that Rebel is selected here. That should auto select inside of the AstroPad app. Again, for this to work, follow their general instructions. It's quite easy. Install the AstroPad Studio on your computer and then connect them to the same network. It's not too hard. Okay, right here, magic gestures. Here I have this modifier key set to Alt. So if I hold my finger on the screen, I can use the color picker, which is useful. But I actually like drawing with one hand versus drawing with two, especially since I'm holding my iPad with the other hand. All right, so let's scroll down a little further. I have tap gestures, one finger tap set to click. This lets me use the artist pad on the left. Two finger tap I have set to shortcut undo. Three finger tap I have shortcut redo, Control Shift Z. This one doesn't really work. And then double tap, this is where I have the setup to keyboard shortcuts, 6 and 7. I have a hard time getting AstroPad to send some complicated shortcuts. It seems to send them one and then the other doesn't combine them quite right. So I can't get the side button to send an undo, but I can't get it to reliably send a single button, like a single key. Now, AstroPad also has a handful of settings. We can go down here to general settings or connection. Retina, this display option, the resolution is going to give you a slower but prettier picture. Non-retina is faster. Honestly, I have not seen much of a difference when it goes back and forth between those two. Connection, you can choose peer-to-peer. This does not use your internet connection. And Wi-Fi, this does use your internet connection. So peer-to-peer, you can look up here the response time. The slower this is, the higher the number this is, the slower it is. Connection quality, medium. And then switch to Wi-Fi, and I would just look and see which one of these will hopefully jump you from medium up to a good. Right here, it'll say good, and that'll be green. Or it'll say something different, and that will be a different color. So in general, I think this app is really nice and responsive. It works only in your home. So at the moment, I know that there's some ways for people to trick their iPad into thinking that it's on a home network when you're actually out and about. I forgot how to do that. I could look it up. I have not tried that yet, but that would be really nice because this works very well. Now, the iPad Mini 7 had a much brighter screen. This would be a great solution for out and about. However, the iPad Mini 6 and the iPad Mini 7 are too dim to use comfortably outdoors. So we are still in pursuit of that solution. An iPad Pro would probably work, but they are very big. And then I could just simply be taking my regular computer with me, and that would solve some issues. Like this little dude. It was fun to draw. I drew this in this app, doing this exact same thing. I was downstairs, my computer was upstairs, I was sitting on the couch and I was holding the iPad, and it was nice. It actually felt very good. All right, if you guys have questions about this setup, put it in the comment section. If not, then go download stuff and have fun and play. All right, you guys, thank you for watching. Until next time, stay creative and have a wonderful day.